All right, let's get going. Good morning. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. I'm not here to make trade recommendations. But I will conduct technical and fundamental analysis, and I'll do so in real time, pip by pip, candle by candle, with the overriding goal of helping you put together trade plans throughout this beautiful New York trading session. If you're trading along with me using a demo account, then regardless of whether your plans are successful or not, you will have an opportunity to learn. Now, trading and investing is a risky business. We know that. That is common sense. But what is uncommon is the high level of leverage that Forex offers you. As an amateur trader, once in a while you may get lucky and the leverage will work for you, but more often than not, it will work against you. Therefore, the coaching staff at fxbootcamp.com recommends that you do not trade real money until you develop a track record of success using a demo account. Even so, the National Futures Association would also like to remind you that past performance does not predict future results, and your success on the demo may not be found in the real world, because the real world has things like greed and fear. So, do not embarrass the Forex trading community by resorting to gambling, which is simply risking money you cannot afford to lose. Today's New York trading session is sponsored by FXCM. FXCM and their MT4 trading platform, which we're using today. FX Bootcamp is a completely independent service. It's not affiliated with FXCM. The advice and education I'm providing you today may not necessarily represent the opinions of FXCM. Alrighty. So we got some moves going on, Hua. Got some moves, a lot of news going on lately. Take a look at the stock markets. Last time I looked, FTSE was flat. DAX was up a bit. Oh, not even showing this. So how are we doing here? Well, coming up to that monthly pivot again for the Dow. I don't think it's that big of a deal. Nothing going on there. We head up to R today, oil's going to 103.50. It's like dollars fading here. I think if we get down to that weekly S1, that's going to be important. If you don't think it's important, I'd ask you, well, why are you using pivot points then? All right. So it looks like we're caught on that, but notice that it's an S1 as resistance. So the big turnaround from a couple of days ago was, I think, very interesting, huh? Weekly M1, monthly M1, guess what? It held the stock market decline. So anything fundamentally change here for the stock market? Well, yeah. First of all, Aussie job report last night was pretty good. Okay. That was a bit surprising. And I think it's tonight, which is Friday, Asia. I think we got news out of China. So if the Aussie numbers are pointing to a decent rebound in China, then that'll stabilize things and that'll be nice risk on. Or if they're horrific, maybe the People's Bank of China will be forced to do something to stimulate their economy, and that may be good. You know, I don't know. I don't know what to expect from them. Probably an RRR change, which is similar to the Fed lowering interest rates. The big thing that the Chinese do is they change the reserve requirements. But I don't know. I don't know. Maybe they're thinking QE3. Right, for them, I think it's QE2, isn't it? But anyways, so So we already got some decent numbers out of Australia. G'day, mate. Ripper. So if we can get some good news out of China or horrific news out of China, either way, you know, maybe we got some risk on again. Okay? And it just has to be, it just happens to be technically perfect for such things. But if that doesn't happen, then, you know, you have to ask yourself, are you a bull or a bear? Okay? And if you're a bear, this is just pulling back and you're going to dump it. All right? We're in the daily five. You know what I mean? Don't get caught up so much on what's going on a 15-minute chart. So, like, if you're just a bear and you believe the fundamentals are still bearish, okay, then you're just looking for this. That's the next wave. Okay. And what I was talking about several weeks ago, I don't know if you're an Elliott Wave person, but not a three-wave correction, but, you know, a full-on five-wave reversal. Pull the stock market way down. And then QE3 in the United States, but only because of the Bernanke put. So, it's hard to say that kind of stuff now. It's basically pure guesswork and speculation. And I'm not even saying that that's going to happen. But the big thing, and it's not on my charts now, but if you recall last month, this was the monthly reversal pivot area. Remember, on monthly pivots, that was a pivot profit zone. I mean, it was so technically perfect for a huge pullback. I mean, that's what we talked about. The only thing that could save it, I think I said, was Mutual Fund Monday, people buying back in, but there hasn't been any fundamental reason to do so. So I think what people are doing is just they're out of the market and they're waiting for earnings season. You know? So maybe we get quantitative easing of some sort in China. Wouldn't that be interesting? And I was reading an article about things are not, you know, fixed by any means in the United States, but we're a lot better off than a lot of other countries as far as the rebuilding of the economy. And the article was talking about consumer spending in the United States is already picking up, and credit is easier to get. It's not, you know, not nowhere near what it was fundamentally before the crisis, but way better than it was before, where some people are getting credit and there are opportunities and people are buying durable goods and people are doing this, people are doing that. So the article was, maybe the global rebound is on American consumers again, the way it was 20 years ago, instead of, you know, hoping China brings things around. Maybe America's the big dog again. So we'll see. I don't know. America may be the only game in town, except for, you know, the Canadians, of course. Take off, eh? So anyways, technically great place for a huge pullback. And then now we're in a technically interesting area for a bounce, and we're starting to get one. So, does anyone here have an opinion on earnings season so far? I know we're only, two or three days into it. Have things been okay? Have things been horrific? Are things way down? Kind of mixed bag? Let me know if you have an opinion. can't sort this by change, huh? Yeah, but besides Alcoa, is there anything else going on, KG? Anything interesting? Alcoa is interesting, for commodity play and stuff. Yeah, KG, you gotta say it was unbelievably awesome or just horrific. But it can't be okay. So look, USD yen mixed bag. USD Swissy, dollar weakness. Pound dollar, dollar weakness. Euro USD, euro weakness. Or sorry, dollar weakness. And no front running opportunities today. Was there a lot of news today in the European session? Excuse me. Even if it wasn't important, was there a bunch of things scheduled? I have to apologize, I sleep that time of day. Saying that muddies the water. Really? No, it's just funny. Then it must have just been quiet. I don't know. I'm just looking at this autistically. I love that new word. Yeah, I was just looking at these currency pairs autistically, and it just, I don't know. Unless it's setting up for a short, I guess. Maybe it's just slow, not fast. I mean, that could be it. I don't know. I feel like I'm walking into an ambush here. So let's just gear down. Well, before, yeah, well, let's look at it pivotly. So did everybody catch that this bottom here in this session? Maybe that is it, but you notice that monthly support pivot? If you thought we had sort of a weird bottom today. cool, huh? Monthly S1. Look at that, doubled bottom and everything. The thing is, and you could, it's the Stokes that I'm kind of looking at too. Time of day, I mean, this is a bit early. So if anything, it's slow, not fast, which is interesting, which means this is going to scream up into resistance and then collapse. Look at that beautiful weekly pivot reversal. Just beautiful. CAD doing what it's supposed to be doing. So technically things are behaving. So if Euro is going to go up and then drop, my goodness, am I sick? Currency traders never get sick, am I right? So we're already weekly central. I wonder if it's going to play that. There's no, we're not even remotely close to anything else for now. What are we, 3160? Yeah, it's really an odd place for reversal. Yeah, I feel like I'm walking into an ambush. I'll say that, let me get my drawing tool. Yeah, what I'm looking for is a reason for the market to do this. Probably just pull back to that monthly. But I don't really see anything that important in here. I mean, yeah, the weekly central, but we've already pierced it. I mean, so maybe we just kind of monkey around here for a little bit. If it heads up, I mean, we got to go from 3160 to 32. I mean, it's 100 pips, right? It ain't doing that today. So I feel like I'm caught in nomad's land. Yeah, my, it sounds like I'm sick. Screw that, I ain't sick. Yeah, so that's the thing, but not, there's no resistance market-wise, and that bothers me, because I like to use the moving averages, not just crossovers, but dynamic moving averages to, you know, to help me discern the turn. But there's no reason to turn, so I don't know. Like, are we trending up? Is it going to be that overbought today? I don't know. Something's not right. Something's wrong with the world today. I don't know what it is. Something's wrong with your eyes. Living on the edge. Neutral on the hour. Neutral to slightly bullish on the 4 hour. Very bullish on the daily. That's what it is. It's a J-Lo, otherwise known as a wide bottom. So it's just going to take a while to turn this beast around, I think, is what's going on here. So on the smaller time frames, I think what it's going to do is like this and like that. Wow, that's interesting. That's a bullish move on the stock market. Triple bottom, right? So, wow. That's interesting. Good earnings season? Probably would have to go with that. Triple bottom month, And it seems to me when analyzing the 15-minute chart with monthly pivots that professional traders are without a shadow of a doubt, in my opinion, using the monthly pivot as support. I mean, they traded it. The money was placed exactly at the monthly pivot today. I'd say it was a coincidence, except it was a double bottom on the monthly pivot. So, and it's taken off with no real pullback and into a point where it seems out of position with 100 pips to go until you get any real resistance. So I'd say we'll probably have a pullback somewhere in here, generally speaking, from the weekly central to the monthly pivot. And then New York stock market opens and we head north. Now, I'm trying to incorporate a daily move. So, I mean, we could have certainly a down day today, but Friday or Monday are still set to be bullish. I mean, triple bottom, right? We haven't had a lower low and we haven't had a higher high. So, just I don't know. This is interesting. But we have a cycle on our side. Okay, I'll give you an example. People thought it was an uptrend, so we got an early move on Stokes. Why have a big pullback if it's an uptrend, right? So we barely got a 382 out of it, and then it took off. Great. Resets at the daily 200 EMA. Standard stuff. Here comes the pullback. Ooh, a little bit too much of a pullback. But, all right, hits the trip bottom and is oversold. So it heads back up. Retest the 200, pull back as you would expect, back down, triple bottom, oversold again. So there's two scenarios here. There's one where we lower high, we go to the monthly central, and then we head down. Things are horrible in the world, right? Or we do this. Okay, now the stochastics isn't going to give you your bias or opinion. You got to look at a lot of things technically and fundamentally. But I'd say we're going up to a monthly pivot test, and its reaction there is going to be important. Okay, so monthly S1 currently is support, so up to monthly central pivot, that's 132.5, which, my gosh, has been important over the last several months. 132.5 is coming to play a lot as resistance and as support. Now it's a pivot. Maybe that's why it is monthly central. And then I would say a pullback, either 131.50 or 131, probably 131. So in the next few days, let's try to summarize it. And I'm setting up my longer-term bias, and then I'll have to align the shorter time frames. But I'm thinking over the next few days, we're at 132.50, and then we pull back to 131. And then we'll have to see where we are in the oscillator. If that ultimately holds, then obviously we're heading back down into this area. Okay? And that's extremely likely. Okay, so that's one big scenario, and of course now I have to line up 15 minute and 1 hour charts and stuff with that idea in mind. Okay, of course the second part of this is the second scenario where you hit this, you come down, and then you head up, and you're going up to this area. Which way, Wayne? I don't know. That's where your opinion comes in. Are you a bull or a bear? Oh, Wayne, why don't you just tell me what to do? Well, I don't know what to do either. But that's what I think's in play. So I think we're going to probably bounce off the weekly central for an hour or two. And then we're going to go up to the monthly central. And that's probably, you know, maybe you find yourself Asia or Europe tomorrow at 132.50. Okay,
and we'll see what happens then. I mean, there's a lot of water needs to go under the bridge yet, but I hope you appreciate what I'm trying to clarify here, that we're in a very interesting area and things have been very interesting, and that probably explains why the 15-minute chart looks a little odd to me, because we're big money's already set the pace and they're like, we don't give a damn about your 15-minute chart, we're going to the monthly central. And again, I say big money because I'm thinking that money was put in the market. Remember, it's not, you know, demo accounts moving price, right? It's people put money. Investors and traders put actual money in the market today in the Euro-USD at exactly the monthly support pivot point. I mean, dude, somebody is making decisions on high time frames. Right? You see what I mean? So now we got to take, our type of trading, our speculator trading, and try to intertwine it on smaller time frames. So, have you ever wanted to be a longer-term trader? Check this out. Stokes way overbought, so you're looking for an opportunity to sell somewhere in there. Bearish engulfing candle, small pullback, maybe you're short, right? Okay, way oversold, so you're looking for a reason to buy. Bullish engulfing candles, small pullbacks, maybe you buy here. Way overbought. Okay, you get your bearish engulfing candle, so maybe sell here or here, depending on when you got your clue train. And then, I don't know, so on and so forth, right? The only thing is, each one of these candles is 1 week. Now, if you have a full-time job, these are the time frames I'd be looking at, is daily and weekly. So imagine, you're waiting for some bearishness, and then you have a full week creating a huge bearish engulfing candle for an entire week, then it pops up Monday and you sell it. Or maybe you miss it because you're waiting for a 382, so you wait out a second week, comes down to your weekly support, and then some green, and then you get a 786, and then Monday's is a red day, and you're developing a red candle right on your weekly 786, so you sell it Tuesday morning, and you're short there, right? And you put your stop up here. And you've been short since May 2011. What? You've been short since May 2011. Whoa, dude. You imagine? That looks great in hindsight, doesn't it? What I wanted to look at is, if I was a big long-term trader, what would I be looking at? I'd be looking at daily charts, I'd be looking at weekly charts, and I'd be looking at weekly and monthly pivots, right? So like this little pullback here, this is no different from a 15-minute chart, and this is a theme I keep discussing with you, all right? It's just your trade setup that's different. Mentally, not metaphysically. But here's a 50% pullback off of a lower low, lower high, I mean, with a Stokes kicker. I mean, that is so straightforward. Classic currency trading, isn't it? And which means you could have been short since February, right? The only thing is, here's 3 weeks of bullishness. So it's hard, right? You don't like losing money for 3 weeks straight, right? But it'd be interesting if you were using these charts a little bit, because you can see what's going on here. And this is basically what's happened this year. So maybe once in a while, it behooves us to take a look at these charts a little more closely, right? So, like, if you thought this was going to break to the downside, you'd play it that way. Okay? Or you can measure last week's fibs, you know, and that's something I do like to do. Do you ever, not last week's fibs, but fib last week? You guys ever do that? That's something I've been teaching for years. You should fib yesterday's trading range, and you should fib last week's trading range. And what you're going to find is they're basically pivot points. But like you could have that where you're like, and you could see the pivot. It's really overlapping. I can't zoom in any more on MT4, but let me drop into a daily now. Okay. So this weekly central pivot is also the weekly 382 Fibonacci retracement. And it looks like really what the monthly pivot is telling me, and this is what we talked about earlier, 3250 is right in here, right? Which is the monthly central pivot point, 132.44, but it's also last week's 618. All right. So if you were a bear, that's the kind of thing that's going to be awesome. On the daily, though, if you're a bull, you're trying to find support, and there's clearly support going back a while here on this daily chart. You like the stochastic oscillator, right? You're starting to get a higher high. So what you would do now is wait for a pullback, and hopefully it's a pullback to S1. And I've already done this like twice. But if you're a bull, you got your bottom, you got your Stokes, you got your move to the upside. You just need a slightly better entry, have it come back down. Maybe you catch a monthly S1. So what you want to do is fib that area, and then gone, right? That's what you're thinking. So in this case, what you want to do is fib it this way. Okay, you take the high, take the low. Okay. Now, I'm guessing though it comes up a little higher first. Let's just even just say 132. We're just guessing, right? Or 132.50 is the other one that I was saying. So let's say it does that. Okay, 132.50. So let's say we go up to 132.50. That's where we are Friday at the pre-London session, right? And then, so that's Friday. So Monday, or let's say Tuesday, New York, we're here at 131, and you say, aha, that's my 618. So that's what I said before, up to 132.50, down to 131, and then sky's the limit. Okay? Capiche? You just have to guess. Flip a coin or actually do some analysis and decide whether you're bullish or bearish. Helpful? I hope so. That's funny, KG. So Coach Kurt is opening up the news trading room. He's covering three different reports coming out. Feel free to zip over there and log in to catch his technical and fundamental analysis of these reports. Remember, if you're in the free room, it's a great opportunity to either learn fundamentals, to learn how to trade news releases, or just catch FX Bootcamp Lite, because you're a part-time trader, you have a full-time job kind of thing. Or if you just want FX Bootcamp Lite, sign up and become a news trader. $99 a month for roughly 20 hours of live training every week. That's a lot, dude. 80 hours of live Forex training for $99. 80 hours for $99. 80 hours. Not just some kid, you know, on his laptop in his dorm room in Bulgaria, but someone with an engineering degree and a master's degree in applied statistics and probably 6 years of currency trading experience. 80 hours for $99. Not bad, dude. Sign up. Kick down, come clean. Don't be a holdout machine. Get in the game! So here's that turn we were talking about. I mean, it's right off that pivot, but it just, for some reason, didn't feel right. I don't know what. Why? I mean, it was late. It was so late. The front run setup was so late that I thought the move was early. Where you don't know if you've been lapped or not, you know? Sure enough, it wasn't early. It's a late move. How interesting is that? So that means maybe things are going to be a little bit different from that original analysis. Now it'd be cool to catch it back down 31. Or maybe it's just a small flip. No, I think we could get back down to 31. That'd be interesting. So now we just got to change it a little bit. All right. So it does a full cycle down to 31 and some change. Could be 31.20, could be 31.00, and then another shot. Excuse me. So which means we start New York in a range and we leave New York to the upside. So here's a 15-minute chart in case you didn't quite get it. Pull back down to, you know, we play this range in here now, right? So that means, you know, we come back down into here, and then, you know, so we play this for a while, and I guess once we get the stinky cheese eaters out of the market, maybe this breaks to the upside. I guess I should stop calling the Europeans stinky cheese eaters. I apologize for that. It's just I'm jealous. You know, the fabulous culture and history. I'm just jealous. I live I live in a world of processed cheese individually sliced and wrapped for my pleasure. Interesting. 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 So, anyways, so if you're a European and you enjoy eating stinky cheese, then I guess it shouldn't be too insulting. But if you're European and you really don't like stinky cheese, you're like, Wayne, I'm just not a stinky cheese eater, and I really don't appreciate being insulted that way, then I'm sorry, dude. Just having fun. But causing hurt and pain should not be, something that brings one pleasure. Excuse me. What would you call an American? A supersizer? How about a double whopper? Because a whopper is just not good enough. One time at a party, we were discussing deep philosophical, topics, which too much alcohol can often do. And so one of my friends, he's like, "So one thing I'm trying to wrap my brain around," he said, "is why McDonald's sells diet soda." I'm like, "Touché." You know what I mean? Like, can I have a Big Mac? But I'm on a diet, so I'll have small fries and a Diet Coke. Because I'm on a diet. All right, come on. We're looking for a turn here. Remember, I checked the five quickly. We're in a nice cycle. Man, sorry guys. Bum 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 ba bum bum ba bum. Dun 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 dun. Did it 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 did it. All right, nice. Good. I'm going to have to adjust here. That's what I want. And you should already know what you want to do, guys. You should already know if you're going to short it or not. I've always said Forex loves you, and it'll always come back for you, but it will certainly not wait around for you to make a decision. It might come back for you, but it ain't waiting. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum.
Okay, we're about 60, about 60% overbought, 66% overbought. So I don't know. I got to make sure you understand. So if you're looking to follow the 15-minute cycle, you want to short somewhere in here, ideally. Ideally, when this is way overbought, and your stop's probably just going to be above there, and you're hoping that at least for the next few hours, that's the top. Currently 70% overbought, 71, 73, 74% overbought. Usually I prefer some overbought and oversold to be somewhere between 75 and 100, you know, 85. To 95 is just stellar. Yeah, thank you. Don't forget, 2.5 minutes from now we got news. But you got to be a Johnny on the spot, which means news could spike this son of a gun straight up to a double top, right? And then it could collapse, and you're just sitting there all over the place. What? This is where having a trade plan ahead of time is extremely important, because I might be looking at that thinking, all right, I'm a bear, let's say. I'm going to trade the 15-minute cycle. Okay, that's fine. News comes out, and it goes up and up and up and breaks through the fibs, breaks through the double top, and just flies up to the next level. That wouldn't bother me a darn bit, because I'm waiting to sell. And you're like, wow, good thing I waited patiently for my entry. Never got the entry, and therefore I didn't jump in, therefore no bloodbath, right? Now, if you're a bull, this is a role reversal. And yeah, then I don't know. You should probably not be selling. And there is room. Like, if the news is surprising and this does spike up to the upside, there's room for the bulls. It just usually it doesn't last very long in this situation, but the 15-minute chart's only maybe, what is it, 73.5% overbought. You know, that, so it hits 75. I mean, it's just barely overbought. So it could go from 73 to 90 still, which means we could have another two hours of straight up. But we'd have to get through the weekly pivot, going to the monthly pivot. But we've already discussed that
that plan or that idea, and you should have a contingency plan for it. About 30 seconds now. So PPI, jobless claims, trade balance, Canadian housing, Canadian exports, I guess, whatever that is. So shields up, red alert. Wait for it, should be out any second. Trade balance, -46. Jobless claims, 380. Wow, that's bad. PPI, 0.0. Canadian housing, 0.3. Let's see, I'd say what? A crappy PPI, more people applying for unemployment than expected. That's not good. But continuing claims is down. I don't have any details on the trade balance. I mean, the headline is -46, but I'd like to see more details. That's not out yet. So the world's going to take a while to figure out what all that means. All right, so if you're a bull, you're a bull, fine. If you're a bear, get ready, man. This is what you want if you're a bear. If you're a bull, you better move your stop. This is what happens when you catch moves that are not super extremely overbought or super extremely oversold. All right. A lot of people would have sold that, placed a stop above the high, which means, let's say you dumped it near 70, you know, the high is just above 80. I mean, certainly you wouldn't need to risk more than, what, maximum 25 pips. And the potential, like I said, probably 131, 131.20. So let's say you risk 20 going for 40 or 50. See if we got more data on trade balance. All right. Trade balance. Negative 19 billion with China. That's lowest since March 2011. Japan, negative 7 billion. Canada, negative 3 billion. OPEC countries, negative 6.5 billion. Mexico, negative 6 billion. European Union, negative 6 billion. So we buy a lot of crap from these guys, huh? Imports, month over month. 2.27 billion exports, 1.81 billion. So just last month we bought $20 billion worth of crap from China, $7 billion of crap from Japan. Now the Canadian stuff, that's not crap, that's good stuff. That's only 3 billion of good stuff though. OPEC, gee, I wonder what we bought from OPEC countries to the tune of 6.5 billion. Mexico, 6 billion worth of stuff we bought from them. It's actually not bought, it's the difference between what we sold to them versus what we purchased. So last month the trade balance with the European Union, the difference was, last month the difference was 8.5 billion. This month it's only 6 billion. So it's a difference of 2.5 billion. What's interesting about that is it's probably Europe doing a lot better on their exports. Maybe a weak euro or something, but I don't know. So anyways, very interesting stuff. And there's your lower low, bada bing, bada boom. So it's my time of the day to shut down the free room. Remember, if you become a full-time member, we got hours and hours of trading net to go for the New York session. If you want to try something, you can also become a news trader with Coach Kurt. Also, I'd like to thank FXCM for making the free room free. and the use of the MT4 trading platform. So if you like what you see and you want to keep your room free, download a demo. Click on the free practice account button on your lower left. Keep the room free, guys. Keep the room free. Cheers.